Okay, so I'm gonna try this again because OBS does not like, even though I'm sitting here recording myself and you can see it bouncing around in here, it's not recording audio. So I'm recording audio separate and I'll fix that later. So what we're trying to do, install Guitar Rig 5 in Reaper so that we can play guitar and sound like anything, anybody, whatever you want to do. So the first step is we're gonna have to get Reaper, and the easiest way to do that is just, honestly, you can Google Reaper, but this is it here. So I usually get the 64-bit version. It's free. It has a little nag window that goes away, but I eventually paid for it. It's only 60 bucks, worth it. So install that, and then you'll have your Reaper set up here. And that's what I'm looking at there. The next step is to download the Guitar Rig player. So Guitar Rig 5 player. And we want player, not pro. There's a difference. Guitar Rig 5 Pro is a pay thing, and don't worry about that. This is just gonna give you a bunch of cool stuff to play with. You don't have to get all 6 gigabytes of stuff, whatever. But go here, click on free download. And the way that you download this is you have to download this other app first that is their download manager and set up an account, and all this tells you on this page. Once you do that, it looks like this, or maybe like that. But you're gonna look for the Guitar Rig 5 icon. And it's going to say install, so you click that, it will install everything. And then you say, oh, I'm ready to go. Not quite. So Guitar Rig 5 is a executable all its own, but that doesn't record. It doesn't root it through Reaper, for instance, or Audacity, or whatever you're doing. So for whatever your DAW, your audio recording software is, you got to set it up. So there's two things that you first want to do. We're going to go to options and preferences. Hopefully it'll show us some stuff. The first thing you'd really need to do is we'll set this up first. So we'll go into VST and we need to add Guitar Rig to this path here. So the easiest way to find out what that is, you can right click on the icon, and then that is an icon shortcut. So you find out where that lives by finding the properties, and it says program files, native instruments. So that's where we're going to go. So I'm going to say edit, add, and I'm going to go to program files, and I'm going to go to native instruments. And I've got the 64-bit version of Reaper, so I'm going to click on that folder and click OK. And the next thing is you got to click rescan. If you add a VST plugin and then open Reaper, it will scan it every time it opens and you're good to go. But if you don't scan it here, you won't find it later if it's already open. So apply, OK. The next thing would be to set up your audio device. Right now, it won't let me show you what that is because I'm already using it. And if I stop, you can't hear me, but I'll stop for just a second so you can see. So you could see there. You can actually select your audio device, and if you don't select it, then you won't be able to use it later. The next step is to add a track here. So add a track, we right click, insert new track. And there's a couple of interesting and useful buttons on here. So the first is to arm the track right there. And if you notice, my top here is on input 2 and my bottom is input 1. So input 1 is my guitar, and input 2, that's really loud. Input 2 is my mic on my particular audio device. And then now we want to add guitar rig. So we go to effects. And if you hadn't already been searching for something, you'll see all the effects that you've got installed here. It comes with a ton, so just use the search menu. So guitar should be the only one named guitar. So you double click it and it will open this larger window here. And this is guitar rig. And now because it's in Reaper, you'll have this extra border. And this extra border is really annoying. It sits on top of everything. You can pin it and whatnot so that it'll just be there forever. But I usually have dual screen, so I'll put it over to the side. But while you're looking, I'll click on stuff. So these are the presets. And you can download even more presets, and you can sound just like anyone you want to sound like. So whatever you want to do, you can do. So one that I found earlier, and it's got different kinds of things. So you can do by song. You can do it by effects. You could do, if you import your old ones from the older guitar rig versions, you can do that. You can select different amps that you want to sound through or model. Let's see, what is it? Songs, as I was at earlier? Or styles, maybe? I can't remember. There's so many of these things here. It's just, it's a lot. So here's Foo Monkey. Okay, double click that. It'll say, the demo runs for 30 minutes. So after 30 minutes, it'll basically turn off all the effects. And that's fine because you could just do 30 minutes at a time. Save your file, open it back up, and then it will run for another 30 minutes. So it's not like it hurts anything. So click OK. So now, you can't really hear my guitar through there just yet, but that's because I'm not monitoring live. So click this button right here. So I'm going to strum, and then I'll click it. And then you can hear what the amp VST modeling or thing is doing. So you got, you know, all sorts of stuff you can play around with in here, and you can actually tweak all these knobs and whatnot, and I don't know that they will help anything. I don't really play with these much. I just download something from other people who've got time to fall down a tone hole until they get something that sounds good or sounds like somebody that I want to sound like. So here's like Nirvana. I guess that makes sense that it sounds almost exactly like the Foo Fighters one here. Yeah, so you can go ahead and listen to these different ones and see what they sound like, see if it's something that you like. All sorts of stuff. But the interesting thing is, as I'm recording this, you can see I'm recording it here. Again, my guitar is input one. I could play around with all this stuff. I can mute it and solo it, whatever I want to do. But the interesting part is that if I'm not using this, if I want to turn the effects off, so let me get something that's kind of... So you can hear... If I want to turn the effect off, I just click the power button next to effect enabled, and now I'm back to my regular guitar. Whenever you close this, 30 minutes passes and it times out, and then you open it again, you have to click on this and open up your Guitar Rig 5 again and click on the same effect that you were using on that track. And you'll do that for every track that you have it on. If you wanted to, for instance, copy the same stuff, all the same settings from one track to another, you just right-click that track, say duplicate, and now I have a second track that's exactly the same as this, but they have their own instances of Guitar Rig 5. And so you could see track 3, track 2, which one is which. and you can have different effects on those, whatever you want to do. So that's pretty much the gist of it. Play around with it, see what sound good. I've got some other presets that I don't own them, but I'll try to find out where I found them and have a link somewhere. But that's pretty much all you need.